fee. They're gonna make a big star out of me. What do you think? What do you think? What do you think?
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another edition of Greg Hogan Rants. In today's episode, we'll be taking a look at the top 10 commercial characters of the 80s.
Attenzione! Give your hamburger an Italiano. Dinner
what
to
the
make with
fuck
hamburger
is
for
that
authentic
thing?
Italian taste. New Chef Boyardee hamburger Italiano. Mangia.
Ah, yes, the Twinkie, the kid. I remember this little guy since I was... Jesus, since I was alive. I mean, I was born in 88, so... But, oh, man. I remember him being, you know, the cowboy, and back, you know, I like the cowboys growing up. Good fucking character right there. That's why I gave him number 7. Now, I remember Stretch Armstrong in the 90s. I mean, I know he started in the 80s, but I remember then they started coming out with Mrs. Stretch and all this and that. And they had a lot of segments in their commercials, like recurring themes of Mr. Stretch saving the day. But, wow, what nostalgia right there. Number 8 definitely goes to Stretch Armstrong. Oh my fucking god! That fucking mouse used to fucking freak the shit out of me growing up as a kid. I remember my dad bringing me there and I fucking have fun, you know, and this and that, but oh my god! Fucking scariest experience I've ever had to have as a child. Meeting Chunky the fucking cheese.
Playoff.
Oh, who could forget this fucking douchebag? Ronald McDonald. Oh my god. He come across a psychotic clown and just an insane pedophile. I have no fucking clue which category he falls in, but this guy, he's a fucking nutcase. I mean, he disappeared in the late 90s. I haven't seen him in a commercial in at least.
And you didn't even
Jesus, fucking like, what, 5-6 years? Ah, yes, who could forget about Spot, the 7-Up guy. I remember this guy had fucking video games nicknamed after him. In the late 80s, even early 90s, he had a lot of commercials, too, with him. Pretty much died out, though, in the mid-90s, I would say. But definitely number 5 goes to him. Alright, now either I could be a douchebag, or I could be a nice guy. The M&M's in the 80s were a great fucking cartoon character, which is why the number 4. Now those of you who grew up in the 90s as well as I did, you know the M&M's of today. The scumbags, the red and yellow one, you know, the douchebags. They're assholes. I enjoy the commercials, but they're definitely assholes. This is when M&M's were still innocent. What the fuck was that?
Well, I'll tell you what. It would scare me because that's how it happened to me when the aliens came into my kitchen and took me up. But they didn't even leave me that can of that stuff that they were carrying and shit. You know what I'm saying?
We're Cosmic Kids!
Okay, I guess I can't say much about Cosmic Kids because I don't really remember it as a child. That's all I'll say about them. But they're definitely number three.
Good food for active earthlings.
Now here's another one that just stays in your fucking mind. The fucking California Raisins. I can't, you'll never forget them. You just never will. Number two.
I see the eyes and brushes looking like raisins and shit. You know what I'm saying?
Honey, are you playing with your food again?
Now here is the number one, the best commercial character of the 1980s. Kool-Aid Man. I mean, come on. Oh yeah! Jumping through the fucking wall. I mean, isn't it fucking every fucking time. This guy is the man. He will never die. I mean, you put out a commercial today, I guarantee you, so many kids will still be on that shit. Kool-Aid Brand soft drink mix. For a kid's big thirst. You know, I don't even know what to say at the end of this episode. So I'm just going to drink this beer, and then I'm going to go lay down in front of a bus.